But the Democratic Labour Party, in a famous opposition response in Parliament, said that we don't care about the police, and that by taking the reins of government, they will give the police duty-free cars and interest free loans for housing. But where are those promises today? Instead, what the police have been visited with is this disgrace that we saw last week. Now let me make it clear. We in the Barbados Labour Party have utmost confidence in Commissioner Darwin Dottin. I have had
that the Commissioner of Police shall have responsibility for the superintendent and the command of the police force in all its aspects, and shall be answerable only to the Governor General of Barbados. That's what he says. That we shall have superintendents and command over all aspects of the force, and he's not answerable to the Prime Minister. Because the law is so drafted as to shield a Commissioner of Police from any involvement from a politician like the Prime Minister, answerable only to the Governor General, and that he must have superintendents and command. So then the Commissioner says, I is right. Yeah, I is not the term right. They can't be other way. Because that, and I can see the emergence. I can start you off, but this is not the time for it. I'm going to have my day to really address and speak to this matter in such detail that when I begin to tell you of the kinds of individuals who have either fallen ill and you would, or other things, you would then begin to understand. But individuals, the process started with a few of them who made it quite clear that this young man here in your presence was incapable of leading a political party. Not because of any lack of ability, but because he was deemed not to have the ability, arguably, not to have the ability to bring resources in. But when I deliver that speech, because we'll take a couple of speeches, when I start to deliver it, you will then begin to understand the extent of this whole journey. It has been a journey. And that the welfare of our country can be affected, and this is the point, it is not attacking anybody personally. The welfare of every Barbadian can be affected if a Prime Minister, by reason of incapacity, is not able to carry the weight of the office. And I think, as I said, that the region is dead in Barbados, where three crises are flowing into one. A crisis of institutional and social disorder on a scale unprecedented in the history of this country. An economic crisis that is now reflecting week by week in the collapse of our enterprises, and for the first time in our history, as we said, we have a voice in the leadership. And Barbados cannot continue like this. This country, therefore, is on the brink of becoming a failed society. Because when these three things flow into each other, it is so easy in a short period of time for an economy and a society to go over the cliff. And you know, we have
that is not a partisan matter. It is not a matter about which we should seek to cast a political divide. But it is a matter about which the Democratic Labour Party must not be inclined to play games. It is not the type of issue that admits to the gymnastics and the public relations foolishness of a Mr. Hartley Henry. It is far too serious and grave in its nature and its portent. Now let me say to you what I think you already know, and perhaps have thought about, even if you have not said it. And it is this, that in several other parts of the world, but this is not the only place that a leader has become ill while in office. And perhaps I should begin here before we go abroad, because right here in this room is a former leader. And he became ill while he was in office. I remember him coming back from, it was Guyana, I think it was, sick, unable to complete a meeting. Owen Arthur told the public that it was an allergic reaction. He indicated with certainty the nature of the medical recommendation that there would be a few days before he would be able to work again, and all was laid bare. Erskine Sandiford of the Democratic Labour Party, a former leader, took ill, had angina, had to be operated upon whilst in office, but there was no secret attached to it. There was certainty. The public was not left to speculate, to gossip, to wonder, to feel insecure. If you go to the United States of America, you got George Bush. He had a growth on the side of his cheek. Doctors said it might be malignant. They made him go under the knife. They told the public what the full nature of the circumstances were. They gave the public a specific plan, an idea specifically as to how long he would be away from work. So too it was with his deputy, Dick Cheney, who had to have heart surgery whilst in office. The president of Nigeria.